Audrey Nuna, damn right. That's who it was. Audrey Nuna, damn right. A little Korean rapper for you guys. I'm a Korean, so I gotta give props. And she's a female, badass rapper. So today is episode number 3-4, becoming a design speaker with Elise. That's me. And this whole series I started is just me with a camera, real fast and quick and dirty. Nothing, obviously, nothing too pretty, no edits. Just me talking about my challenges, struggles, tips, suggestions, and ideas for you guys around my journey trying to become a full-time design speaker. And I'm getting closer and closer to that goal. So I'm excited to share my stuff with you. If you have any questions, any thoughts, put it in the comments, and I will try to address that in my next videos. So today's topic is trying to get money or getting money getting money through social media, really. And first thing I want to talk about is just a brief little history, so you kind of have an understanding of where I'm at with social media to give you a base and an understanding for yourself. So I started 2 years ago. I started doing YouTube, one video a week, pretty consistently for that first year. Since then, I'm kind of not as consistent, but I post here and there. And then Instagram, I post about 2 to 4 posts per week pretty consistently for the last 2 years. And I recycle that content. So something I do a video on for YouTube, I will also post it on LinkedIn as well as Instagram. And posts I do on Instagram, I also post on LinkedIn. And if I do any reels, I also post it on TikTok or vice versa, right? So I'm always trying to figure out ways to reuse that content, blast them all out there. I am probably what you consider a micro influencer, not a huge number of followers. And so to give you some numbers here, I got about 4,000 followers on YouTube, 14,000 on Instagram. I've got about 7,000 followers on LinkedIn, 2,000 subscribers for my email list, 1,200 followers on TikTok, which averages about to 30,000. Probably some people are on both platforms, so probably around 20,000 followers or subscribers. So that's where I'm at now, and it's taken 2 years to build just that. And I think that even probably having 5 to 10,000, I already started to see the benefits from, see this is what happens when you have no edits. So I already started seeing benefits after just a couple thousand subscribers and followers. So I'll talk a little bit about that. And one other thing is I do lots of events. You may have noticed, so I did about 60 events last year and then about 30, 40 events this year. So that's another way that I get people to get their little eyeballs on me. So one thing that I get money from, or one of the streams from social media, is client work, design work. And I roughly get on average about one client inquiry per month. The other thing I want to mention is some of them do come from Behance. So that's another opportunity and a place where I would recommend designers to put your work in order to get some projects. And of those, about one of every 3 or 4, I'm actually interested in the project. So that kind of gives you basis for that. But the most important aspect isn't necessarily finding new people through my hashtags and whatnot. It's about just being top of mind to the community I'm already a part of. So people think, oh, Elise UX, and they relate those two together because I'm constantly posting every week and they're like, oh, there she is again. And they might not even watch my videos or even read my posts necessarily, but they see my name constantly pop up and they go, oh wow, she's really engaged in the community. She's passionate about what she does. And I think that just that alone has given me opportunities. So putting your work out there, constantly having or thinking about cadence or being consistent is very key for this one. The other thing I'm getting opportunities is from universities as well as through and enterprise companies. So doing boot camps, UX, like intro to UX, intro to Adobe XD, things like that. Because students are looking at my content and they reach out to like an instructor or a coordinator or something like that within their university and they reach out to me directly. So that's been a way that I've been gaining some more event clients or workshop clients, as well as enterprise clients as well. That's not, it's like, I haven't been pushing as much for enterprise, but I just recently got a couple clients and it's pretty lucrative and really fun. So I think that's something I want to focus more of my attention on. Also, big one here is Adobe Live and all of the stuff that I've been doing with them. That's a big part of my, or big aspect of my revenue and my income. An interesting thing was I had already, about 3 or 4 years ago, I was already working with Adobe as a contractor. And then I just posted on my LinkedIn some videos. And right away, after like the first few videos, someone from Adobe reached out to me and was like, hey, do you want to host Adobe Live? They go, oh, she's a designer who also puts herself on screen. Does she want to get connected in this way? And that was like the spark of it all. And from that, I got opportunities to become an Adobe XD Enterprise instructor. Then I started becoming part of their community events. Just recently, someone found me through Adobe, a marketing department that's related to Adobe, but they had no idea, like any connection with my previous stuff. They just saw my posts and saw the hashtags I used and asked me to do another type of marketing, some other sort of marketing through that. So it's interesting kind of how all these pieces are playing together. So keywords are really important here and pushing your content out there and seeing that butterfly effect happen. And to that point, through my Adobe Live stuff, more boot camps, I got connected to boot camps, Springboard, Career Foundry, and General Assembly. Those boot camps started to reach out to me for events, workshops, as well as video series. So that's another form is video content that I do as well. Okay, let's talk about what I haven't done, ways that I could make more money and that you guys can think about for yourself, which I'm like late in the game. I'm super late in the game with this. And I kind of like feel a little bit like down on myself every week. Like, okay, you should really think more about affiliate marketing. So if I'm talking about Adobe XD, if I'm talking about a product I really love and someone purchases that product or downloads the app or what have you, I get a percentage or I get a certain amount. And I have not taken advantage of that opportunity at all. So this is another area where you can make money from social media. The other thing is that I'm really thinking about right now is creating my own products. So selling directly to my audience. Right now I'm getting paid always through a larger company, an organization. And I haven't actually sold anything or tried selling anything to the audience. And I've been thinking about what I want to sell. And the first thing that I've been thinking about, which let me know what you guys think, is a workshop on speaking and talking about your portfolio or how to present your portfolio. And that could be predominantly, I'm thinking like in an interview setting, but it could also be just like talking about your work and speaking publicly about your work. And so this is something I've been thinking about doing a whole workshop on. I've done a lot of stuff with case studies and whiteboard challenges, etc., but I haven't done as much about presenting. So this is something I've been thinking about selling, and that's something I'd like to reinvest more of my time in for the next few months. What do you guys think? What do you think about that? All right. I went over a bunch of tips through that. Tip. But the number one takeaway is cadence. Cadence, and consistency. And y'all will start to see some benefits. And if you start doing this and you start to see some benefits, again, even just from a few posts, it's like kind of like an interesting experience where you're like, so-and-so saw this and they responded and wrote to me and then referred me to so-and-so. You start to see that butterfly effect from your consistency, even in the early beginnings. That's like really exciting and fuels you. Let me know how that experience is for you. I'd love to chat about it and to connect on it. All right, I'm gonna leave you with some Audrey Nuna, some Damn Right as I say goodbye. Happy Friday, hope you have a good weekend, and I'll see you next week. Yeah. Oh, where's the music? There we go. I'm there, bonita. I'm there, bonita. I'm there, bonita. I'm there, bonita. I'm there, bonita.